Hello, welcome to my video. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to convert Earth Engine JavaScript to Python script and Jupyter Notebook. And so to follow this tutorial, you need to install the GEMap Python package. If you have not installed it yet, you can follow my other video to install the package. Okay, let's get started. So we are going to use the example. I provide the notebook example here. You can go to my GitHub repo, examples, notebooks, and we're going to use the Earth Engine JS to IPY notebook. And so you can either download this one or you can use Git clone to clone the GitHub repo to your computer. I already have this one here on my computer. So all I need to do is to type Jupyter notebook. And then to open the tab on your on the computer, then we can get into the example notebooks and Earth Engine JavaScript. So it's a very simple process: import the library and then import the module within the conversion GEMap conversion. There are some functions there that I developed to automatically convert JavaScript to Python. So all we need to do is to find some examples. You can directly run this example if you want. So I'm going to clear the output just to show you, and then you run all. It should be able to automatically find the script. It's not in here, but we're going to use the example here from the Google Earth Engine, API. And if you go into the GitHub page, JavaScript, source codes, examples. So there are a lot of examples provided that by the Google Earth Engine API. And we can quickly convert this JavaScript to Python script and Jupyter Notebook. So how can we do that? Simple, let's go back to this and then git clone. Then we can come back to our computer here. All we need to do is just to open the browser, so you can open the terminal from here, or not from here, from your home folder. Let me see here. I already have this one. I'm going to delete this one first, and open the terminal. Then we just git clone and paste the URL. Okay, so we have downloaded the entire Earth Engine API. Similarly, if you go into the folder, this is where all the JavaScript examples are located. So all we need to do, copy this URL and then come back to the Jupyter notebook. Open this one. So all we need to do is just to replace this one with the path that we have. And you don't need this one, you can comment up. So the only thing that you need to set is to pass the folder where the JavaScript are located. And once you have this, all you need to do is just execute. Before we do that, I'm going to delete one folder. Let's go back to delete this one, because these are all the empty, almost 1,500 JavaScript. Those are just empty one, not really useful. So we just delete the folder. Then we can come back to here and just hit run. So you will see here we have 78 JavaScript being converted less than 1 second. So nice. Next, you can use Visual Studio Code to open the JavaScript that have been converted. So I'm gonna open in here just to show you what it looks like. And so if you go to the source code examples, and then for example, you can click any folder. Now you see the JavaScript, right? Those are the JavaScript, and those are the one being converted to Google's engine Python script that can be directly used in QGIS. So if you have QGIS, you can open QGIS, and then you can load the data. So I'm gonna open a new folder, and you can load the base map first if you want, and go to the Python script console. And then from here, then you can load any, for example, any Python script that we have converted. So examples, and then you can do anything you like. For example, let's collect from which one we like. Maybe normalize difference, okay. And then all you need to do is just hit one. Then it should be able to load the data to receive the data from Earth Engine and then give you the data. So very, very quick, right? So there's no manual editing that you need. Everything is automatic, converted from JavaScript to Python that you can use directly in QGIS. So next, there's another step. So from QGIS, we want to, for example, create Jupyter notebook. So all we need to do is just execute this code block. There's also, you just need to pass in the folder and going to get the template. So the template is from the package. Just keep this one. And then all we need to do is execute. Then you see automatically converted all the source code to Jupyter notebook. So right now, if we come back to here, you will see right now we have the JavaScript. We also have the Jupyter notebook. We have the QGIS one. And so if you open the Jupyter notebook, it will open directly on here. So now you have this all converted to Jupyter notebook. There's also another one, .py. This one was converted from the Jupyter notebook. So it's how the Jupyter notebook was created. It basically, it was created based on this file to do the automatic conversion. And then right now you can just simply do it from here to execute the code interactively. And now you have all 64, how many? Come back to here. 78 JavaScript automatically convert to Python and Jupyter notebook. You can also execute the notebook if you want. Basically, if you not execute, your notebook is just the code. There's no output. So if you execute, you will save your output. And so you can directly uncomment this one. And then you execute. So this one might take some time because executing the notebook might take a while because it need to connect to Earth Engine and then to do all the computation, then return the result. So might take some time. Okay, so that's all for this video. If you enjoy this video, please consider hitting the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Otherwise, I will see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.